Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Bingyang Wei, a computer science professor. Every semester during advising, I hear the same question. How should I spend my time in college to prepare for a CS career? That's a really good question, because the truth is, the job market today is very competitive. You cannot just drift through classes and expect job offers to land in your inbox. If you're a first year, you're just starting to explore. If you are junior or senior, you might already be stressing about internships and jobs. No matter where you are in this journey, this advice is here for you. The earlier you start, the better prepared you will be. But even if you are late in the game, there are still steps that you can take today that will make a real difference. So, if I were a CS student today, knowing everything I know, here is the advice I would give myself.
Advice 1. Discover your path.
One of the first things to figure out is your interest. Computer science is a huge field. Web development, mobile apps, databases, robotics, AI, cybersecurity, quantum computing, Internet of Things or IoT, blockchain, and more. There is a very cool YouTube video called Map of Computer Science. It gives you a bird's eye view of how the field fits together. Check the description of my video. If you're early in your journey, don't stress about picking a specialty right away. Get through the fundamental courses quickly, like Intro to Programming and Data Structures. But once you do start to find your interests, don't just rely on classes. Connect your curiosity to the bigger picture. This is where I say, watch where the money is heading. There is a saying in hockey, skate to where the puck is going. That's exactly how you should think about your career in computer science. And one of the best ways to see where the money or the puck is going in computer science is to look at venture capitalists or VCs. You're like, I'm not a business student. Remember, VC's whole job is to study trends and bet on what's going to be huge in the next 5 or 10 years. When firms like Y Combinator or YC, Sequoia, or Andreessen Horowitz, or A16Z invest in something, it usually means that field is about to grow. Follow their X, YouTube, or LinkedIn accounts today. You will have a front row seat to the latest conversations happening in top VC firms, and see firsthand what these smart, forward-thinking leaders are doing right now. For example, AI pioneer Andrew recently spoke at a Y Combinator event about building faster with AI. Here, Jeff Dean from Google is sharing his view on transformations in AI at a Sequoia event. Next, let me show something. Let's go to the Y Combinator website. Here you can see the companies founded by YC, like Stripe, Airbnb, DoorDash, Reddit, Dropbox, and so on and so forth. If you click Companies, you can view all the companies founded by YC. For example, here, in the summer 2025 batch founding cycle, YC founded 169 startup companies. And you can quickly scroll down and take a look at all those companies. So here it shows the types of startup companies YC founded. For example, 112 B2B companies, 10 fintech companies, 13 consumer companies, 3 education, and then healthcare, real estate, industrial. And if you scroll down, you can see that almost every company is using AI agent. That's not random. That's a signal of where the world is heading.
Let's check out one startup founded by YC. For example, Tacto AI. As you can see, this is a very small company that currently has only 2 members. Here is a brief description of this company, the background of the 2 founders, a YouTube video, description of the problem, solution, the motivation, and they are also asking for future collaboration. Sign up here, reach us directly. So actually, feel free to reach out to those people. They recently just got funding, and they may actively look for contributors, interns, or full-time developers. So use our classes to explore your interest, but keep an eye on the market, when you can align what you love with where the world is going. That's where the best opportunities live. Okay, so that's the big picture. But what about today? What can you actually do this semester that will set you up for success? No matter what year you are, these are the things you can do right now. Advice 2. Build skills early. Here is one truth. Don't wait to be taught. The best students, the ones who land internships and jobs, always learned a little extra on their own. And it doesn't have to be complicated. For first-year students, learn data structures early by yourself, because every internship interview will test that. Learn some SQL, because every company stores data somewhere. Build a simple website, learn some HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, because showing something you built is way more impressive than just listing a class. And maybe dip your toes into AI. You don't need to become an expert, but understanding the basics already sets you apart. And the resources? They're incredible. Honestly, YouTube alone can give you a computer science minor if you use it right. I have linked a few channels in the description. And don't forget Coursera and similar platforms. Some of the world's best universities, like MIT, Harvard, Stanford, Berkeley, put their courses online for free or very low cost. You can literally learn from the same professors who teach in the Ivy League. Imagine walking into an interview and saying, "Yeah, I worked through Stanford's machine learning course on Coursera." That shows initiative that sets you apart. So don't wait to be taught. Learn beyond class. Advice 3. Grow your network. I have seen students apply to thousands of jobs online and hear nothing back. And I have seen other students shake hands with one alum at a university event and walk away with an internship. That's the difference. Connections matter. In my opinion, the alumni network and your professors are the hidden superpower of going to college. Please appreciate those resources. Don't waste them. And here's something just for you as a TCU student. I created a private LinkedIn group called TCU Computer Science Alumni and Students Network. In this group, our alumni and recruiters periodically share internship and job opportunities. They may also offer internal referrals. If you're not in there yet, join. I'm sure other universities have similar mechanisms for their students. So how do you reach out to alumni? Here is a simple LinkedIn message template. You can say, "Hi John, I'm a CS student at TCU interested in AI agent. I noticed you work at Amazon. I'd love to hear how you got started and if you have any advice for someone looking to follow a similar path. Thank you." Remember, start your conversation with curiosity, not asking for a job or internship directly. Once you build a relationship, then you can ask about internships or referrals. Oh, by the way, the Department of Computer Science at TCU periodically invites alumni to come back and give talks. So don't miss those opportunities. Show up and talk to the alumni to grow your network. Please be polite and professional when reaching out to alumni. So Don't hide behind your laptop. Connections open doors, resumes cannot. Advice 4. Get real-world experience. For example, internships. Let me be honest. If you graduate without internship experience, it's going to be very hard to land a job in today's market. Companies want proof that you have applied your skills in the real world. The good news is, for first-year students, you have 3 summers in college. That's 3 golden chances to gain that experience. Use them wisely. Don't waste them. Some students think internship is only for junior students. That's not true. At least, it's not true in computer science. Many companies hire first-year students and sophomores. Big-name tech companies like Google, Amazon, and Microsoft hire first-year and second-year students. Many local tech companies have plenty of opportunities as well. And you don't have to search blindly. There are resources out there. Check out the description of this video for a curated list. And don't forget, ask alumni, professors, your university's career center, and even family connections. Every summer is an opportunity. Don't waste it. Advice 5. Contribute to open source. One of the fastest ways to level up as a software engineer is by reading other people's code. In your classes, you mostly see small toy examples from textbooks. But in the real world, code is complex, messy, and constantly changing. Open source gives you access to that world for free. Here I list several URLs that you can use to find your favorite projects on GitHub, probably the world's largest code repository. And it's not just the code you learn from open source projects. On GitHub, you can actually see the conversations around a pull request or a PR. For example, so here is a pull request from the Spring Boot project. As you can see, developers discuss design choices, ask questions, review each other's code, debate trade-offs, and enforce coding standards. That's real software engineering. You cannot learn that from a classroom assignment. Now, a lot of students think, well, contributing to open source sounds way too hard. But it's really not. Maintainers of popular open source projects are often overwhelmed. There are many open issues out there that nobody has fixed yet. They may need documentation completed. They may need more test cases written. So you don't have to solve the hardest problem on day one. You just have to start. Maintainers will appreciate every bit of help. In the description of this video, I included several articles on how to contribute to open source projects. And I want to point out that some of those maintainers are developers at the companies you dream about. And once you start, something powerful happens. The open source community begins to know you. So you're not just another student taking classes. You are part of a living, breathing software project. Advice 6. Keep your GPA strong. Many people will tell you GPA doesn't matter. And it's true, you don't need a perfect 4.0 GPA to get a great job. But GPA is still a first filter for many employers. It shows consistency. I have seen students who couldn't get jobs. And when I looked closer, many skipped classes, didn't submit assignments, didn't ask questions in class, didn't participate in any alumni network events. I've also seen students complain, I've sent 2,000 applications and I didn't get a single interview. But when I asked about their habits, it turned out that they were not putting in the effort in class. They got C's and D's here and there. They were not building projects. They were not networking. Sending out a bunch of applications does not fix a lack of preparation. On the flip side, I have seen students who worked hard, showed up, asked for help, and got involved. Those students always found opportunities. Maybe not always at Google or Meta, but at banks, real estates, insurance companies, trading firms, startups, and government labs. Solid jobs that built real careers. And here's something most students don't realize. Your professors regularly get emails from recruiters asking if we know any strong candidates. And guess who do we forward those opportunities to? The students who have been consistent, who we have seen put in the effort, who we know can deliver. Hard work and engagement don't go unnoticed. So, think of college as your current job. If you don't perform well at this job, why would an employer trust you with the next one? The last advice, join communities and conferences. Now let's talk about something most students underestimate, communities and technical conferences. You might think those conventions and conferences are only for professionals, but the truth is, they are one of the best ways for students to grow. Why? Because when you go to a conference, you are not just listening to talks, you are stepping into the real professional world. You are meeting engineers, recruiters, alumni, and peers who are just as passionate as you are. For example, national career and networking conventions, like Grace Hopper Celebration for Women in Computer Science, SHIP for Hispanic Engineers, and NSBE for Black Engineers, have incredible networking and job opportunities, and they're open to college students. There are big technical and developer conferences. For example, Java 1, Spring I.O., VueConf, Dev Nexus, and so on, where you can learn directly from the people building the tools you use in class. And of course, there are a lot of local meetups, like Code and Coffee and hackathons. And here's something that you should know. Most of these conferences offer special student discounts, sometimes 50%, 70%, or even more. But here's the catch. They sell out very fast. So if you see one, don't wait, grab it. This is one of the best investments you can make in yourself. I know it's not cheap, but trust me, it's worth going. And also remember, many conferences are hybrid or online now too. You can join from your laptop, often for free. When you show up, people start to recognize you. And just like open source, this is networking. Again, I've seen students land internships and jobs because they met someone at a conference booth, or because they ask a good question in a Q&A session of a technical talk. So don't think of conventions and conferences as just extra events. Think of them as stepping into the future version of yourself. If you want to belong in the professional world after graduation, start belonging now. So here's my final thoughts. Your 4 years, ages 18 to 22, in college might be the most valuable learning years of your life. Later, you will be busier with work and family. Right now, learning is your job. Don't waste it. And remember what we talked about today. Discover your path. Skate to where the puck or the money is going. Build your skills early and take advantage of world-class resources, many of them free. Grow your network. People open doors that resume cannot. Get real-world experience through tech internships. Contribute to open source. Keep your GPA strong. Again, work hard, show up, and be consistent in class. Last but not least, step into professional world through communities and conferences. If you do these things, you won't just graduate with a CS degree. You will graduate with opportunities, with confidence, and with a vision for where you want to go. So don't wait until senior year to start. Start right now. Be proactive, stay curious, stay connected, and most importantly, believe that you can create value for the world through computer science. Be passionate. That's the mindset I'd want if I were starting my CS journey today. Okay, next, I'd love to hear from you. What did you find most helpful? What questions do you still have? Or if you are further along your CS journey, what advice would you give to CS students, especially first-year students? Drop your thoughts in the comments below. Your ideas might help someone else who is just starting out. Thanks for watching.